Hello and welcome to the MBS Show, episode number 502. I'm your host, I'm Sanzo, and we got some news for you this week. So, let's hop right into it. First up is full Make Your Mark Chapter 2 soundtrack now on YouTube, with its releasing on all streaming platforms. The Make Your Mark special soundtrack is now available at good old YouTube. I've compiled up the links and made a playlist for it for easy listening. It's actually really good. There's got some serious talent pumping out songs for the new series. Go listen below the playlist. Unavailable. Alright. So here we are. These are all the songs and phone, please don't bother me. I should put you on the silence because you are bothering the recording. Yes, there we go. So anywho, where was I? Yeah. If you notice here, the soundtrack is on YouTube, but it's not official. It's not done by who now? Hasbro or the official MandoPony YouTube page. I'm going to mute the desktop recording for this. So if I were to click on this and try to hit in. If I'm not mistaken, this will also play through the speakers. Okay, yeah, I managed to mute it. So it's done, it's uploaded by a third party. Foil Age Sama, and like I mentioned before, it's not officially uploaded on the YouTubes, so result may vary, but it is still the song, the whole album, available on YouTube. If you want to officially support them, go do so on Spotify. But if not that, maybe you can hop onto their this. I mean, it's available, it's there, go listen. I haven't yet. I don't know. Honestly speaking, I like the motivation for season 5. It's not that I don't like season 5 or generation 5. It's just that I'm lacking motivation, that's all. Let's carry on with the next news before I hop into other things. Next news is My Little Pony 40th anniversary logo revealed. Okay. Despite what a lot of people follow in this fandom of ours, My Little Pony has actually been around for forever, 40 years in fact. In a news issue of Isu, the logo of the upcoming 40th anniversary has been revealed. They also wrote a blurb about it, which I'll include below. It doesn't say anything we haven't already know, but it's fun regardless. Update. Added a cap of the 5G5 section from. Okay. Alrighty then. My Little Pony continues to elevate itself as a pop culture icon, as the brand can be seen on shelf at all major retail and e-commerce store through product partnership that introduce the brand to all new audience, along with major promotional partner. The brand's 40th anniversary kicks off in 2023, complemented by a slate of content, continuing to drop on YouTube and Flix throughout the year, delivering 550 minutes of original animation. this spring, Hasbro celebrates the successful launch of the 2D short series My Little Pony, Tell Your Tale, along with the recent new release of My Little Pony Make Your Mark series, centered around the theme of adventure with stunning CG animation that match the look of last year's hit movie My Little Pony: A New Generation. Okay, what's this? I guess it's something. Let's see. My Little Pony brings new generation ponies. Wait, didn't I just read this one? Okay, I'm gonna skip that part for a bit. So yeah, from what I read here, like Seth mentioned, nothing we didn't know. Next year is going to be its 40th anniversary. They've been around for a really long time, and yeah, that's pretty amazing. That's pretty cool. So yeah, when you really look at how My Little Pony G5 or its newest iteration is trying to put itself out there, it's very interesting with the way that it's doing it. You could say that this is new media, new way of marketing, new way of doing stuff. When you take a look, see at the olden days of doing stuff, let's take G4 example. G4 is a very good example. Back in the days when it came out, it was a made-for-TV series where Hasbro at the time had created a new channel called The Hub, I think, and it premiered on October 10, 2010. Funny enough, that's also this anniversary date for My Little Pony. So Hasbro has its own channel, put it up there, make shows and so on. They really didn't think nothing of it, but the fandom came in, latched onto it, enjoyed the show very much, and pushed it to new heights. Back in the days, Hasbro was very confused and didn't know what the heck was this, and they were afraid of the sudden popularity. And they slowly got into, how do I put this? They slowly embraced it, but cautiously. You can see it with their, I would say marketing strategy, but they you can see it with their plans or what they did. Essentially, what they tried to do was, okay, what do we want to take out of this? We can sell our, not really sell, but we can lease out our brand. And hence, you got stuff like Funko Pops, T-shirts, and so on. Also, branded items from perfumes to this and that and so on. So that's how you technically got not the traditional stuff from previous generations. And then you got the video games, which was not to the point where fans really wanted it. And that, I mean, you got the Game Loft game of the Town Builder stuff and whatever Game Loft did. So you got that too on the scale of entertainment and so on. And then you got music and so on. And it's pretty different from the regular content that previous generations has been doing. Now, back to G5 now, you can clearly tell that, okay, we got new people or new blood in the system, we got new ideas. So what do? Let's try this, which is putting stuff on YouTube and see how that goes. And it's been a rocky start with G4, but they kind of stabilized and cemented their way of doing things with G5. They kind of make the new generation movie on the Netflix, put it up there instead of going to the cinemas. I do believe there are some theaters that did show it in cinemas, so that's good. But they're doing it with Netflix and so on, and then posting little snippets on YouTube, and then doing the Make Your Mark thing on... Was it Make Your Mark? Or what was it called? Yes, Make Your Mark. So, put Make Your Mark on the Netflix again, soundtrack and so on, and little snippets on YouTube. So, that has been very interesting with how they're approaching G5 and how they're marketing it. Don't forget the comic books. Those also done wonders for them. Another side avenue. Let's see. There's also games. Yes. Now G5 has a Switch, PlayStation, Xbox game, also Steam. So they're really pushing it in terms of how we want to market the brand, which I kind of find very fascinating because we didn't have that before. We have it now. So I like to see that. I want to see where this goes. And I want to see if the plan that they have pans out. We do still have some other G4 things on the way. If I'm not mistaken, we had a perfume line that's available in Japan. Also, the deck building game that's coming out, I think. Ah, man, I forgot who made it. But I talked about it before. And but what else? What else is there? I think that's about it. But so, let's see where G5 goes. Because G5 is an interesting premise with what it's trying to do and how it's handling things. So, yeah, that's got to be very interesting. So anywho, let's move on to the next news and the final one, please. My Little Pony Pin... Oh, G4 again. My Little Pony Pinball now on Epic Games Store. For all the people that didn't have access... For all the people that didn't have access to it on the Apple Store, Epic Games now has My Little Pony Pinball available for download as part of Pinball FX. You have no idea what this is. It released a while back, exclusive for Apple. You can find it with your kit. So, I think I mentioned about this one before. Alright. So, breakdown of what this is. So, this is a board on Pinball FX. It has pony teams. I need to break it down even more. First thing first, what is pinball? If you got no idea, pause here and go do a YouTube search or a Google search, because technically it's a game, a arcade game. I'm gonna pause here. I'm gonna wait. You guys wait. I'm gonna wait for you guys. Welcome back. So, now that you know what pinball is, Pinball FX and some other brands are known for their digital games. Pinball FX is one of the more well-known ones. So, Pinball FX available on Epic Games Store, I think. I'm curious, is it... Give me a second. Is it available on the Steam Store? Huh. It is? That is? Let's see. Pinball FX 3. Okay. That is fascinating. Let's see. Give me a second. I think I can share this with you guys. So yes, Pinball FX. Yes, there is. So what it is basically a digital pinball table where you can have certain boards. Usually what I see here is, for example, this one, Williams. Williams is a very well-known pinball developer where they make tables and so on. Real-life tables, by the way. What's going on here is that they're digitizing the Pinball FX or the Zen Studio, the developers, are digitizing the board and putting it on digital for so on. What I'm looking here is that this is the FX3, while the My Little Pony board is a newer board, I think. So yeah, that's totally something different. Okay, close this one for a bit. So now, back to this one. I think this newer version of Pinball FX is available on the Epic Games Store, where you can get newer boards and so on. I believe that the Pony board, you need to purchase it, if I'm not mistaken. I don't really remember, but it could be a purchase. So anyway, with pinball, you have certain goals, like get a certain score, hit a certain target, do this, do that. And yay, it's a lot of fun, but honestly speaking, what you really want is a physical pinball machine. But the problem with a physical pinball machine, that it is stupid expensive. Is it very expensive? If I'm not mistaken, it could cost you around a grand or 3 grand or so on. So it's not cheap. So having it digital would be much better. Technically, you won't have the I'm not sure. I'm not an expert at pinball, but I love pinball. So anyway, this is a good alternative for you guys who want to try it out. I personally don't have an Epic Games Store account. I don't want to start one just because I don't want to have multiple gaming accounts. The one I have, Steam, even GOG is one of those things where I don't really remember how I got it. I just have it. So yeah. So anyway, if you guys do have an Epic Games Store account and like ponies and don't mind trying pinball, give it a shot. Yay. So let's move on to the next topic. And the next topic is, what have I been doing with my week? So this is rare because we have another news topic for the week. Yay. Previously we didn't have that, so this is good. This is really good. So, what have I been doing my week? Technically, nothing much. Just work and stuff. Weekly Magic the Gathering meetups and whatnot. Oh, I don't have my deck with me. Here's something. Recently, there was an anime convention locally near me. I didn't go because I didn't want to be in a pile of sardines with the pandemic still around. Mind you, even though we got our booster shots and so on, the pandemic is still around and it's affecting people. So yeah, I don't want to be in a crowded place with that. I mean, yeah, people think that, people think that the pandemic is gone. But no, it's still around, and people think that, okay, if it's still around, it's just like the common flu. Yes and no. Some people bodies affect them differently, and I don't want to risk it. For all you know, I might be bedridden for a while because my body couldn't take the pressure of pandemics and so on. So yeah, I ain't gonna risk that shit. So let's see. Back to story. A friend of mine went and asked me, "Yo, Norman, there's this Malay version of Vanguard, Card 5 Vanguard. It's the trial deck in Malay. Would you like to get it?" And I told my friend, "Why not? Just for the lols." And I got it. The packaging is small, similar to a deck of cards. Like the box is this small, so they didn't waste much paper on packaging, so that's good. I haven't really opened it yet. Why? I don't know why. Just because, I guess. You know what? I'm gonna open this in front of you guys. I'm gonna close the camera for a bit. Take it out and stuff. Give me a second. Boys, camera back online. Yep. So, let's go this one. Okay, yeah. Oh, that's just my dice. Give me a second. Put you aside, Magic the Gathering, because it's time for Vanguard. Woo, that's dumb. So, I don't have the... you know what, give me a second. I'm so committed to this bit, I want to show you guys. Oh no, am I not clear enough? Is this not focusing? No, that's the foreground. Okay, here we go. I think this is the best I can do with what I have. Alright, so now this is the box for the Malay version of Card Fight Vanguard. Sorry. So, as you can tell, the box that it comes in is pretty small compared to... Give me a second. Compared to a Magic the Gathering version of the box, that looks something like this. Oh boy, this is how a Commander Precon looks like, and this is a trial deck for a Vanguard deck. The size difference is huge. If I'm not mistaken, there's also ponies, but I don't think I have it here, and I think I opened it. There's an unboxing on my channel. Go take a look, see. So, let's see. So, I'm gonna open it. You know what? I'm gonna open it for you guys and take a look, see, and tell you how the card quality, cardstock feels. So, I'm gonna open the side. There you go. One of the few things I noticed that the card is printed in Singapore and distributed in Malaysia. So, yeah. Oh, wow. It even... okay, here we go. Open the box. Okay, they're doing the classic Vanguard stuff. So, here we go. Here we go. Oh, boys. Damn it. One of the few things that I started, I won't say disliking, but found Vanguard cards is that, sorry, one of the few things I like about Vanguard cards is that the card stock for them are thick. You can't really tell, but okay, if I wonder if you can hear this. Compared to your standard Magic Gathering one. I don't know if that makes any sense to you, but the feel of Vanguard cards are much thicker and they feel better in hand compared to your standard Magic Gathering Yu-Gi-Oh! Sets. Also, there's the... Oh my god, what's this? Oh god, there's rules in Malay. Oh, there's what do they call it? Index? Yeah, there's indexes, and sorry folks, this is my first time opening it, and I have bad eyes, as you can clearly tell. Okay, I thought so. So, the Malay version is not really Malay, but more Indonesian. For you guys that didn't know, the Malay language shares a lot of its wording from Indonesian, but Indonesian has its own slang, its own, how to put this, its own way of saying things that sometimes it can sound different from Malaysian Malay. You could say it's similar to how French is from French France and French Canadian. So, yeah, I'm going to put that aside because that's distracting me. So, yeah, Vanguard, oh god. Never thought I would pick this up again. But it's just all the fun, so just to have a laugh, and yep, Malay. And you guys are probably wondering, Norman, we explained to you us that you bought this for the lulz, so are you going to play Vanguard? No, I quit. Long time ago. One of the few things, oh god, this is going back to the why I don't want to play Japanese card games again. Oh god, I'll just summarize it. One of the few reasons why I don't want to play Japanese card games anymore is because of a thing called power creep, and that is the game relies heavily on you getting new product from the company. You cannot sustain your current deck to compete with other decks because other decks are much powerful and other decks are more newer products are much more powerful compared to older products, and the term power creep comes there. With new product coming out, they want you to get new products so you can get better cards, get better blah 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 and so on. With Magic the Gathering, it's not so much to that extent where older cards are still good, they function really well, and are still competitive with the newer things that are out there. Sometimes it's even, you can say that it's even better than the newer cards. So, hard talk aside, I'm gonna wrap it up here. So, anyway, guys, if you guys have any questions, concerns, or suggestions for the show, you can contact us at mbsshow@gmail.com. You can also reach us on the Twitters. The show's Twitter account is at MBS Show, and my personal Twitter account is at Ron Sanzo. Also, please subscribe and rate us on iTunes, YouTube. Don't forget to press the bell icon to stay up to date, and also Stitcher Radio, and also like our Facebook page. You can catch us on MandoPonyLive.com. Links will be in the show notes. Also, do subscribe to the Review and Discussion podcast on iTunes and Stitcher Radio. Over there, you can catch me, Silver Quill, Jacob Totera reviewing pony comics, episodes, specials, movies, and whatsoever. Sometimes we like to do other things than ponies. That can be video games, comic books, animes, cartoons, movies, or whatever. We do a lot of stuff. We like stuff. Also, if you'd like to support the show, you can do so at patreon.com/MBSShow. With every support, you get a week's early access to review, discussion, podcast, exclusive, and deleted content. And a huge thank you from me. Talking about the thank yous, I would like to thank Jacob, Lucky Knight, Jeffrey, myself, Lag, and also Tristan. Thank you so much, guys. You are great. So anyway, I have been Norman Sanzo. I'll catch you guys next week with another fun episode of MBS Show. See ya!